left-to-idiot reporter says Trump's being played by Rocket Man, Sarah shuts him up for good. The liberal media was stunned by the news that North Korea's Rocket Man, Kim Jong-un, had stopped his nasty rhetoric and was asking for a meeting with President Donald Trump. One idiotic reporter attacked White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders, trashing Trump's accomplishment and saying that the president was being played by the Rocket Man. Well, Sanders wasted no time shutting him up for good. President Donald Trump has cornered Kim Jong-un. Over the last several months, the White House has made life hell for Jong-un by enforcing heavy sanctions with China's cooperation, and now the Rocket Man is running out of money, fuel, and food. Jong-un has no other choice but to ask for a meeting with Trump, and it's a sign that the president is winning. The mainstream media can't stand it, and immediately they are making lame arguments and hoping that Americans will see this meeting as a disaster. Business Insider reported, it looks like President Donald Trump may soon be face-to-face with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, and some experts are already blasting the meeting before it happens. The U.S. has been getting played and outmaneuvered the past 3 months, and it's happening again, right now. Anyone who thinks a Trump-Kim meeting would resolve, or even help, the nuclear issue is forgetting history, and that's separate from the risks of Trump's mouth, Ben Jackson, who calls himself a defense expert but is really just a liberal hack, wrote on Twitter. This is why one idiot press pool reporter attacked Sanders, insinuating she was lying about why Trump is meeting with Kim Jong-un. At Friday's White House briefing, he sarcastically said, "There's no guarantee this will be any more than a photo op." Kim Jong-un gets his equal footing, in his view, on the world stage, with the leader of the free world, and the president gets nothing. Sarah looked up and destroyed this idiot reporter, answering, "I certainly disagree with, I definitely don't think that the president is getting nothing, when we've already said, and, frankly, I've said it many times since walking in here in the last 10 minutes, that the president will not have the meeting without seeing concrete steps and concrete actions take place by North Korea." She then went on, "So the president would actually be getting something, and, frankly, the world would be getting something. If we can get to a place where North Korea is denuclearizing, that is a massive step and it's something that will make the entire globe much safer." And even President Moon has said that this is because of the leadership of President Trump. Isn't this what the liberal losers wanted? They trashed Trump's tactics with Rocket Man, saying his name calling and tweeting about having a bigger nuclear button than Jong-un was counterproductive. Most went as far as to call the president crazy, claiming he was going to incite Kim into a nuclear war. Now that his tactics have worked, they are saying that going to the meeting is all wrong. Well, which is it? Should we just do nothing and let Jong-un continue launching rockets until one hits, or should we try and negotiate? Let's be crystal clear about Kim Jong-un and Trump. That tweet by the so-called defense expert is really ridiculous, saying Trump has been outplayed by Kim. Trump knows Jong-un can't be trusted. He knows all that the Rocket Man wants is our money, food, and fuel, and then he thinks he'll keep his nuclear plans going forward. We all know that. Trump isn't going to that meeting to negotiate. He is going there to dictate to Kim what will happen if he continues his rocket launches and continues to threaten the world. Rocket Man and his regime will cease to exist. Let's recall Trump's stance towards Kim Jong-un. CNN reported on August 8, while at his golf resort in Bedminster, New Jersey, Trump said, "North Korea best not make any more threats to the United States. They will be met with fire and fury like the world has never seen," he said, with his arms crossed as he addressed reporters. No one outplays Trump. Don't the Democrats, the deep state operatives, and the mainstream media know that by now? They tried like hell to make sure he didn't get elected, illegally spying on him and spending over $2 billion on Clinton's campaign, and still, they lost. Americans sounded off on Twitter, disgusted with the anti-Trump media. Think about what happened yesterday. Trump and Kim Jong-un agreed to meet, the FBI confirmed they are investigating the Clinton Foundation, huge jobs report of 313,000 new jobs. Trump announced tariffs on steel and aluminum and today stocks are up with all the news, tweeted Stonewall Jackson. Let the naysayers complain and have long faces as they refuse to give our president credit for one darn thing. President Donald Trump is damned if he does and damned if he doesn't when it comes to the leftist on CNN and MSNBC. Americans are secure in the knowledge that the president we elected against all odds will never let a murderous dictator who inherited his regime outsmart him. The thought is comical. Barack Obama's way was to bow down to the Iranian mullahs and send them $150 billion in taxpayer dollars. Donald Trump's way is to have the strongest military as our threat if Kim refuses to back down. Peace through strength works much better than bowing down to a murderous regime.